that was sort of interesting when we talked, because you, and I don't know why we didn't mention, why we didn't think of this before, but when we see these hateful videos, you know, there's literally thousands of them. It's to the point that if you key in black women or black women are in YouTube on the search bar, you have this slew of negative videos that are the most heinous things. Uh-huh. And it really does not allow for really any black woman to have a safe place without experiencing some kind of harassment. Uh-huh. And so, you know, according to YouTube's terms of service, we are a protected group, are we not?
You are. You okay. are. And it is potentially considered hate speech, depends on what's said.
And but even if the other people are black, so even if the people who are saying this are also black, is that considered hate speech?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely, because they're targeting a protected class.
Okay, first, ignore the date. I had began working on this whole project barely an hour after that little streaming conversation, interview, whatever, that Christelyn Karazin, copyright, had with her so-called attorney, this web cyber attorney or fair use attorney or whatever the heck he is or whatever what heck he proclaims to be. I don't know if he's legit or not. I don't care. I didn't bother to look. I don't want to look. That's not the issue. But as I was getting ready to try to go through all this mess and take care of it, right on the edge of midnight, I was just so dead tired that I just could not even follow through with it. Plus my film editing equipment and all that stuff is still acting like it doesn't want to cooperate with me. So after all that, and after what should have been a really decent night's worth of sleep, I wake up with like one of the worst migraines and intestinal issues, whatever, that pretty much incapacitated me for the majority of the day. And on top of that, had my people over at my job trying to call me in to work on what was scheduled to be my day off, and that really didn't settle too well with me. So I had to wait for the illness to subside, and then throughout the day, whether I was feeling better and when I started feeling worse again, and I kept yo-yoing back and forth like that, and I decided I wanted to try to go ahead and say something on this whole issue. I can't get a quiet spot to really make sure that there's no unnecessary background noise going on, because thanks to all the hurricane weather that we had recently, a whole lot of yard work needed to be done, and so there was that going on, and all kinds of loud motorized sounds, and people walking around back and forth, yakety-yakking, and it's just gotten to the point now where I'm finally getting to where I can feel like I can concentrate on something and not worry about having to rush to use the facilities, let's say it nicely. And that now that I seem to be coming down off of that, now I'm tired again. But I really do want to get this out in as much of a timely manner as I can before it fades from everybody's memory, assuming that anybody's watched it or paid attention to it. But that introductory clip, I highlighted that because I hope everybody paid absolute closest attention to that, because in everything that was said during that little snippet of that interview with Christelyn Karazin, copyright, that she essentially shot herself in her own foot is basically what happened, and she doesn't realize it. So what she's attempting to do as far as trying to set black men up, or the so-called black woman basher brigade, trying to set them up for a major hurting because she's going to try to flex supposedly some legal muscle and encourage people to go after these black woman bashers and tear them down and tear them apart and get them banned from WhoTube and make, you know, let's get the point across that your hate speech is not allowed, we'll come and get you. She has absolutely no clue that everything that was said in that little brief snippet automatically backfires upon her. Now let me explain, in case many of you didn't really catch it or didn't get it or really weren't paying that much attention because you were so much on an emotional overdrive that you didn't really stop to break down and analyze exactly what was happening here. So let me try to break it down a little bit. In this little interview that she did with her, supposedly, her lawyer, image of Christelyn Karazin, copyrighted, don't forget the copywriter, her image is copyrighted. Just so we keep getting that point across, since she doesn't seem to understand that once you put your image up there in a public forum like that, once you put your voice and your commentary up there as a public forum, anybody can take that and use it to create their own counter commentary. Hello? That's why I put the splash screen up there. Go look it up, go read it up, go read the law. So you don't have absolute exclusive retention and protection of your image or of your speech or of your voice or of your words or any of that nonsense. You decide you want to play in a public playing field. That's part of the price of playing in a public playing field, is that you get to be scrutinized, analyzed, and critiqued. So with that said, let's go back to the first thing that she mentioned here, or that I want to highlight. She made the comment that black women, or the recipients of this so-called black woman bashing, well, they're a... I'll get to that whole protected class part later. Well, no, let's start with that. Because let's get straight to the point, because let's identify who the protected class is here. So she wants to claim that black women who receive all this negativity, all this scrutiny, all this hard-hitting criticism, as it were, that that makes them victims of hate speech. And as such, that means under WhoTube's guidelines and terms of service and all that garbage, that black women are automatically and unambiguously designated as a victim class. That in turn, they are, or that they constitute a group or a special interest group that is designated as a protected minority or a protected class. Sometimes I really hate liberalism, but let's go with that. So in Krusty Crotchrot's mind, black women who receive any kind of negative critique are automatically designated a victim class, which is to be protected from all the mean things that happen from and all the negative scrutiny that they find themselves subjected to, and in part of designating themselves as such a victimized class, which needs all this nanny protection, because women are so weak, and black women especially, are just so weak that they don't have tough skins, they can never face a challenge, they can never be tested on the issues, so you must always run like crying little whiny babies to mommy and hiding behind her skirt and, mom, big mommy, protect me, because I'm just a little child, I'm never going to be able to grow up because the world is just too mean. Thank you very much, feminism. You must be proud of yourselves for the fine job you've done in empowering women. That's your legacy. And my legacy is that the yard work is starting up again. And they've been doing this the entire day. So, anyway, part of her way of proving and showing as evidence the fact that black women are these poor, helpless victims that are just being brutally attacked and victimized and all the other catchphrases, she proclaimed that the definitive test to prove that black women are the victims of such nasty hatred and vitriol, including from black men, of course, was the fact that you could just type into the WhoTube search bar and just type in black women are, and you will see, what was the word that she used for it? I think she said like a whole slew of links to negative commentaries, negative comments, and that there are the thousands of these comments that are out there just bashing on black women and poor me, we're victims, we can't fight for ourselves, so we got to get a big daddy. And he's a black man too, by the way, isn't he? This lawyer that she grabbed a hold of to try to get her. So there's her black man running to her defense, that she was like, oh, but this one requires payment. Oh, so I guess that doesn't count, does it? But anyway, since this is the test and this is the guideline that she says that we need to follow to determine that, or to give a factual basis to that accusation that black women are just victims of all this brutality and all this meanness and all this hatred. Well, all right, let's go ahead and conduct her test and see what we pull up when we type in black women are into WhoTube's little search bar. This is interesting. Let's see. So, in conducting our little search, we have black women are unattractive, ugly, the worst, destroying themselves, crazy, the problem. So, out of, what is this, 10 link categories to drop down, one of them did not complete, so I scratched that out. A total of 6 are decidedly negative, and yet here are 3 positive. Black women are not ugly, black women are gods, and black women are beautiful. That doesn't look like a whole slew of negativity to me. In fact, that looks like a fair balance. Not exactly equal and even across the board, but that's a pretty nice little mix there. But to hear Chris, let me call her by her proper name, but to hear Krusty Crotch Rot say it, she would have you believe that every result for black women are that was typed into WhoTube's search bar would come out almost entirely negative. But this is her evidence. This is what she presents as her proof that black women are hated, that they're victims of hate speech, that they're victims of cyberbullying, and that for that reason, anybody who engages in any of these areas, well, they must be gone after, they must be targeted, and ultimately, they must be shut down and silenced. Are you sure, Krusty Crotch Rot? Are you absolutely certain that that's the standard that you want to hold for what defines hate speech and cyberbullying? And are you absolutely, positively certain that your response to it is actually what you want to pursue? I hope it is, because if that truly is the case, then I've got bad news for you, sissy. And as I said, this is where it backfires on your ass. Because watch what happens when we conduct a similar search, only this time we take out the preceding WO from women and we type in instead black men are. Oh my golly golly geez, look at this. As Gomer Pyle would say, well, surprise, surprise, surprise. Let's see. Out of the 10 subject links that drop down from the search of black men are, every single one of them expanded. So there's not an empty space such as it was on searching black women are. But now let's compare results. Black men are weak. Black men are losers. Black men are cowards. Black men are ugly. Black men are stupid. Black men are too weak for black women. Black men are evil. Black men are sellouts. A full 8 negative results show up versus only 2 that are positive. Black men are the best, and black men are gods. So, who's the victim of hate speech now? tell me again, who is the victim of cyberbullying again? Could you repeat that for me, please? Because I got news for you, dearie, and it ain't good news. Not for you, and not for the position that you hold. And here's something else that you might find somewhat interesting. A considerable number of these black man bashing videos that these link over to are actually uploaded by black men. So, Krusty Crotch Rot, let me see if I understand you correctly. Since you say it doesn't matter if these are black men who are crapping on black men, that's what you're insinuating when you say that it doesn't matter if black men are quote-unquote crapping on black women. Well, I'm an egalitarian. I believe in equality across the board. So whatever is good for the female is good for the male, correct? So if that's the standard for the black men who are criticizing, calling other black men sorry, pathetic, no good, weak, the worst thing since rotting roadkill, that we should collectively go after these anti-black male black men and get them shut down, right? What's that? No, they serve and suit your agenda by allowing them to stay up. A bit hypocritical there of you, don't you think? And besides, you ever wonder why these black men, even though they severely critique other black men, why they're still up and why they're still allowed to do so? It's because black men can handle critique. It's because we can handle being challenged on our BS. And oftentimes, we'll try to come back with a counter-argument to excuse our BS. As dishonorable as that may be, but that's our character, that's our nature, that's what defines us as real men, to be able to endure the assault and hit back, and try to hit back harder. But you weak, sissified women, you little whiny, boo-hooing crybabies who don't understand the first thing as to how to handle tough criticism, whenever other black women come to these forums and decide to confront you on your BS, who tried to tell you that your dirty, unchanged panties stink too, and that you need a wake-up call, and that you need some attitude adjustment, and that you need to learn how to swallow that nasty vitriolic attitude that you're so famous for. When fine young black women who are pleasant to be around, who didn't make lifelong mistakes early in their lives, who could still hold their heads up with some sense of pride and dignity, who actually not only received but earned the respect of decent black men, of respectable black men, names such as Colonel of Wisdom, Statuesque One, Lioness Reloaded, Humble Queen. You know, these are just some of the more immediate names that just fly off the top of my head right now. But did you see what became of them when they decided to step into that arena? So at least your swirling sisterhood there, or your otherwise black man-hating sisterhood, at least there's one area where you operate from a position of at least some consistency. Because when black women come out of the woodwork to confront you with who you really are, like a mad nest of hornets, you come out in swarms and bitterly and viciously and ruthlessly attack these black, your sisters, don't you know? In case you forgot that, to the point where they can't endure the pressure. They can't endure the hatred. And regardless of how much understanding, respectable black men have their backs and try to give them that extra boost of strength to tell them to strive on, and bear under the heated missiles of your enemy. But you evil black women, you evil ones, are such yokozuna in your dirty, disgusting, vile, rotten, crotched games that it's only a matter of time before you end up shutting these decent, quality, concerned, caring, and loving, respectable, and honorable black women and stretch them to the breaking point to where they feel they have no other alternative than to simply bow out, lick their wounds, and walk away with whatever little sanity that they have left before your relentless onslaught stresses them to the point to where they will crack and fracture and fall apart. You did this. And now you're trying to do it to us, and it pisses you off that we won't break like that. Because you managed to identify a common weakness in the female of your species. And any time a decent, honorable, high mark-scoring black woman ever presented herself on the scene as the positive alternative to your garbage, you waste absolutely no time in ripping her to shreds. Gotta love that sisterhood. Way to go. So you see, you're not as tight-knit as you think you are, because your very actions against those of your very own prove that you are filled with nothing but bitter hatred and rottenness. And in trying to destroy black men, after every other dirty, underhanded tactic that you've tried to use against us, which kept failing miserably time and again, no matter how many different times, no matter how many different ways you attempted it, we still stood strong against your lunacy. And we'll stand and rise above this one as well, to where you try to sic another black man against the so-called Black Woman Haters Club. But that'll fall apart too, especially when you find out that anything along those lines that you're even thinking about going is going to cost you some money. And I doubt very seriously if your white sugar daddy is going to grease your palms like that over some BS, because you're too much of a baby just to take your licks and get handed your ass back to you when you find out that things aren't exactly going your way as you had planned. So what do you have left? Oh, only the ability to spew out the same old tired nonsense, such as Anna L. posted in the comments section of my last upload, where she says, quote, "There's nearly a decade's worth of videos of black men trashing the black woman," unquote. Yeah, but interesting how that conveniently leaves out that black men have had to deal with black women's vitriol and anti-black man hatred for the past half century. But we get barely one-fifth of that time in defending ourselves against your hatred and your vitriol, not to mention your whiny, crybaby, childish behavior, and your nasty attitudes to boot. But no, it's a problem for you when we have only a single decade to air our grievances, because black men are not supposed to have any sort of a platform when it comes to challenging the black woman on her BS. We're supposed to be just like good little toadies like we were for the past half century and just bend over, take it, and oh my queen, how can you abuse me again today? That crud does not work anymore. And it really shows you how to the point of desperation that you are when we hear them crying out, "Black men, they abandoned us after slavery, they abandoned us." You don't know your history, bitch. And yeah, I said it. You don't know your history. For you to even try to pull that garbage up. Oh, you want to scream and holler when these southern white redneck hicks go around trying to put a whole new spin on the Confederacy, trying to proclaim that we had 250,000 Negroes that fought for the Confederacy and the Confederacy Army. Oh, you'll scream and holler about that, about how somebody doesn't know their history and that they need to do some research. But the moment that you say black men abandoned black women with the end of slavery, then you want to do your best Rush Limbaugh impression. "I am always right. You don't need to search their information or do any search news. I'm the only source of news that you need." Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, suddenly doing real historical research. Amazingly, that's no longer the way to go. Go figure. Because anytime, a black man ever got free from the bondages of slavery, whether if it was pre-Civil War and he somehow got his manumission by either paying for it himself or out of the goodness of Massa's heart, or out of somebody else, like their church of friends paying for their manumission, or whether it was by means of escape. The very first thing those black men always made their top priority was to track down their wives and their children. So don't even try to pull that BS garbage out of your skanky, stanky panties. And oh, when it was the days of Jim Crow, when did we ever leave you then? Even if we wanted to, we couldn't. Because that was the law. That was the way society was structured. We had to go to our own. And in so doing, we had to be committed to our own. So there was never a time in history when the black man abandoned the black woman. But come the late 60s and early 70s, in reality, it was the black woman who abandoned the black man. And now that the black man has determined that, okay, we'll only go where we're appreciated, where we're wanted, or as Anna L. and her swirling scissor sister says, go where you're celebrated, then suddenly, if it wasn't every hateful thing that you could say about us for selling out, then it was those disingenuous crocodile tears telling you about, we'll leave us, we'll change, we'll try again, we'll make things better, yes. Just making sure that you always had us wrapped around your little finger so we could go and do absolutely nothing to where we could pursue our own happiness. But we got hip and wise to that game, and we decided that, look, the time has come for us to turn our backs and not look back. And that so ticks you off, because now you know you're ending up holding a pig in a poke. Because no matter how often you might say it, go where you're celebrated, black woman, go where you're celebrated, ain't nobody celebrating you. That's why Krusty Crotch Rot did that whole, went on for about 20 minutes, just crying and boo-hooing and mucusing all over the damn place, because she got set back to a dose of reality by a white boy who said, look, this is the way it is. I don't want you. Most of us don't want you. And if you need further evidence of it, all you have to do is go on any dating website. Can't tell you the number of black women going to my profile, checking my little scrawny, effeminate-looking ass out, with skin so pale I could probably pass for Casper's cousin. And yet, it's already been studied showing that black women, are the absolute last to be selected where it involves any sort of interest as a potential dating prospect. Black women are consistently at the bottom. And if that study is not convincing enough for you, or sufficient enough, then here's a university study, which the swirlers kind of brought to everybody's attention, thinking that this is going to justify us and our swirling girls, because see, black women and white men marital relationships have the lowest divorce rates of any interracial relationship, including black men and white women. Yeah, I think it would show considerably lower numbers, considering the fact that you are the last fillies being chosen to be taken out of the stable. Don't you get it? So surely, the lower interracial marriage numbers amongst black women and white men are going to be lower than among the rates of black men and white women, because typically the more people who get married, the higher your divorce rate, because we have a high divorce rate, period. Interracial, racially exclusive, whatever. Divorce happens. And pretty soon homosexuals are going to start getting a taste of that reality. Because they wanted marriage so badly that they didn't stop to think about the fact that marriage comes not only with all the perks, but also with all the baggage and all the detriments. So I can guarantee you that if there was ever an independent survey conducted amongst divorce lawyers as it related to the issue of homosexual marriage, I'd be willing to bet some coin that if they were not 100% in support of homosexual marriage, then at least 90% of them were. Because more divorces, no matter what kind of a marriage it's from, more divorces equals more lawyers' fees, more court time, ergo, more money. But here you are, right here. All your pathetic, go where you're celebrated black woman. Well, it's obvious that you're ticking black men off to no end. But if you think that you're going to find your salvation in the arms of a white man, here are your figures right here. Oops. And keep in mind, these are just respondents to this study. But if interracial dating was such the hot ticket item amongst black women, then these charts should reflect considerably higher numbers. But amazingly, they don't. Gee, I wonder why. And this is why you feel this unyielding need to shut us down and to censor our voices. Because you know it's game over. For black women in America, it is end game. Because even though most black women are still marrying black men, there's either something to be said about the quality of the black men that they're engaging with, or they always have to have that nagging, needling feeling in the back of their mind, which torments them into suspecting that maybe they're not getting just quite everything that would be normally expected from an intimate relationship. Because as I explained, black men now understand that even at a deep subconscious level, most black women despise them. There is in most black women an innate hatred for the black man. And black men recognize this. And so in understanding this, even if he does marry you out of some conviction to keep it black, or he feels intimidated by crossing over, or whatever his reasons, but knowing that he's going to involve himself with somebody whom he knows right from jump has deep-seated hatred for him regardless, then that's likely going to translate into him not wanting to really give his best or to give his all in the relationship, or to be just somewhat aloof or holding back in some way. And you have no one to blame for this except for the black woman who stares back at you in her mirror. And that's all that even needs to be said on this whole topic anymore. Now come sick your black male lawyer after me for handing your ass back to you and supposedly violating your copyright. End of line.